glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Yesterday afternoon at about 4:25 p.m. local time, there was a magnitude 3.9 earthquake near Santa Paula, California, not far from Ventura. 1,230 people said they felt this earthquake and reported it to USGS. 10 minutes later, there was a magnitude 2.6 earthquake near the same location that 9 people said they felt, and it was a thrust earthquake. This one here, the second one. The first one was a strike slip earthquake. The fault line moved a little bit northwest. USGS has an image of what happens during a thrust earthquake. The one side of the fault stays stationary where the other one rises up. This example would probably be a reverse thrust earthquake, even though it's called a thrust earthquake because of the angle, the steepness of the fracture. And I've talked about that before. A thrust earthquake would be more of a gentler slope, or a reverse thrust would be a steeper angle. But I guess I just want to give you an example here of what a thrust earthquake is. Interesting that Dr. Lucy Jones posted a Twitter shout out here. It says that they do have the deepest earthquakes in this location there in Southern California. But the article she gives a link to talks about the water that comes up from this area where we have the subduction of the Pacific Plate under the North American Plate, and how the water comes up from these great depths. You know, as we have the Pacific Plate subducting underneath the North American Plate, you know, it brings down the fluids along with the crust of the earth. And as we get down to the mantle, where that hot magma is, how the water evaporates, rises up and creates earthquakes. Some of the replies to Dr. Lucy Jones. One here says, felt this quake scared the F out of me in Los Angeles. Another one from Carmillo said, thank you. I wasn't sure whether it was an earthquake or my grandson running down the stairs. Another, Kevin Day, said, just like Northridge, most people are unaware that this area too can have serious quakes, up to, if not exceeding, a magnitude 7. Nothing new, really, for anywhere in Southern California. Another, not a day in Southern California without bringing up the old saw earthquake weather. After living in California for many years, no, I believe that earthquake weather is real. There's a small town there. This, using Google Earth, is the location of that earthquake. There's Carmillo, Thousand Oaks, Santa Monica. Let's see, and down here would be Ventura. Earthquakes in California. Here on the live stream is that earthquake. Right there is the second one, which was the thrust earthquake. And I really didn't see anything since then. Let me go to what's showing right now. Oh, we got a small one right here. And looks like we got some movement. Let's pull this. See how sharp these are? This is what you call tectonic earthquakes. Here's that other one. I'll show you. We'll close this out and I'll move it over right there at the top. This here is a paper about the Fillmore earthquake that occurred in 2015. And the moment tensor balls, the majority of them, are thrust earthquakes. That one is not. That one is not. But these here, see how much wider? Let me make that bigger for you. Yeah, these are thrust earthquakes. But this paper talks about the water that comes up from the subduction of the Pacific Plate actually causing the earthquakes in this location. Yeah, that hot magma down there in the mantle is doing this. So USGS gave it an intensity level of 5, meaning it shook for 2 to 5 seconds. Felt by nearly everyone. Many awakened, some dishes, windows, and so on. Broken. Cracked plaster. Yeah, you might want to check out the foundation. Hopefully the gas lines are okay. Unstable objects. Turnover. Disturbance of trees, poles, and other tall objects. And if you have a pendulum clock, they may have stopped. So, did you feel any of these earthquakes? If so, please put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.